Snagger's the joint venture. If you sold the site, and again, you collected the TIF revenue and you paid the CAM to that, what would your cost be? And again, you go down to, you see through the first 20 years of fairly consistent numbers on that. And again, that's the debt, because again, you have to finance the facility that you're creating in that, because you've sold that, and we're assuming that the city is going to be responsible for that. Plus, they're going to have to pay the CAM every year. And the CAM's consistent. It's just their floor on that, $20,000. So if the city sold this to someone, 30 years, it would cost them $2.3 million without an ownership interest for the two floors, $1.4 million on the three floor, and about $400,000 on the four floor. And the difference in that is, again, the reason that it goes down with the floors is because of the TIF revenue on that. The TIF revenue early is greater, and again, just remembering the assumption we made that the city is going to take that money as income to the city, that I could put that back into the project.
Just to clarify, so the TIF revenue that would be coming to the city, their portion of it, you're factoring as
yes.
project revenue.
Yes.
Right? That's,
yeah.
And then the $20,600 here on this two floor, for example, is that?
It's a CAM.
That's CAM only. That's now retired.
That's retired. That's CAM. That's CAM that you're going to have every year.
But the debt retired just for your second floor, if you're buying just the second floor, because that gets retired 20 years?
Right.
Yes.
Got it.
And the CAM is only for the second floor, too.
Right.
Right.
CAM continues forever and ever.
Right.
And that assumes a flat CAM rate, too, which probably is conservative. So now,
real quick, Cam, on the other ownership model where Loveland is the owner, did you account for that ongoing building maintenance to kind of make the CAM
yeah,
on
that's,
the other side?
Yeah, that's was in.
Was in there. Okay.
You can see the maintenance escrow
yep.
on the top.
Okay, that's what that was. Got it.
So now I just kind of put them side by side so that you can take a look at them all together. And it's a 10, 20, and 30 year model. No vacancy, no increase. 10% vacancy in escrow, the 30%, and then the joint venture on each of those numbers. And those are everything that we've gone through in this, and you can see the cost of that. So again, if you go to like at the bottom of that, the 30 year totals with no vacancy, no increases, you can see the numbers. 10% vacancy in escrow, no increases, 30% vacancy, no increases, and then the joint venture.
So you got 5 million swing on the 4-4 between no vacancy and 30.
Right. And it's greater when you go to increases here. And this
1%.
Is with, yeah, this is just a 1% increase in the vacancies. And again, I think the more realistic or, is really that 10% vacancy with a 1% increase on that. If you're going to look at those numbers and just looking at the cash flows and where the city would be in that, and that is the total cash out for that period of time. So each of those numbers for like in the 10 year, that's at year 10, 20 years at year 20, and 30 is at year 30 for that. Again, I think it would be unrealistic to think that there's no vacancies and a 1% increase in $6 million, but if you go, next to that at 10%, that's attainable to, a cost of the city on the 2-4 $1.2 million to, on the high end, of generating $3.5 million of revenue for the city.
And with city ownership, the further we go out, the more you see our revenue increasing after the debt's paid off. To where with the joint venture, we would have that CAM forever, and our costs are actually going to rise in the out years.
Right. And then, you know, is assuming again, with that escrow in there, if you assume the escrow in there, you're protected for your structure. In that if you don't assume the escrow into that, then that would be, you know, again, cities, municipal corporations, typically they don't escrow that money. It's like, well, if we need a new roof, we don't worry about the roof in year one, we worry about the roof in year 20. And we figure out how to pay it in year 20. As a business, you wouldn't do that. Generally, and this assumes that you're going to treat this like a business, you're going to escrow that, and it's going to be, you know, an apples and apples comparison between, you know, the joint venture and, you know, the city ownership. Because if you get into a structure where you're actually going to lease space, you're going to have to take on the characteristics of an owner, you know, a for-profit owner generally.
Do you do any modeling on what this asset's going to be worth in 20 years after it's all paid off?
You mean to sell it?
Yeah. And what would you? Maybe you got $8 million into it today versus, you know, if, and the reason I ask that is that somebody asked that question about this place 30 years ago or whenever they built it. I wonder what that answer would be. And to my point that with the four story, you have three stories that are highly marketable, and actually four, because it's all usable space that's convertible and adaptable. So I don't know if that factors into any of this decision or not.
Again, I didn't do that, but I would agree with you on that. When you take a municipal structure like this, if you had somebody come in and appraise this, they have to come in and look at, well, who, number one, who would buy it? What would they use it for, and then what would it cost them to repurpose it for whatever facility that they're going to use that for? You're exactly correct in my opinion, because if you just had a single story structure like this, well, this probably is not a residential structure, a repurposed residential structure. It's potentially a commercial structure. And to bring it to true Class A, you know, again, I would say that's probably not Class A right now, but it's typical municipal structure. But if you brought this up to Class A, you're probably going to put $45 to $60 a foot inside of it. And then what is the structure worth and all that? Whereas if you have, just to your point, four floors, of that, you have three that are already rented, in that you're going to get into a business model in that, and then on the apartment residential right now, for a cap rate, you know, I was just talking to somebody that they just sold a facility on a cap rate of sub five or less than five cap rate on that. So
that's 20 times net operating income,
yeah,
on an annualized basis, which is crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy money right now.
It is. But it speaks to the fact that, again, you're building and having something that has, you know, unforeseen crazy lifestyle changes, has value on the top two floors and on the bottom two. I mean, you know, you read about retail pulling out of malls and stuff, but a restaurant service industry on the side of the street retail's not taking the hammer.
Now we're cooking with gas.
Here we are.